Here's the guy that makes it all happen right over here.
And you may be wondering, who's this standing next to me? It happens to be Larry Megan.
Hey, Jim, it's great to be here.
Oh, my goodness. Look who is here. Oh, my God, it's Larry Megan.
Hey.
President of Sterling, in person, right here.
Larry Megan here. Nice to meet you, sir.
Thank you so much.
It's
good to have you with us.
It's so great to be here with you here on the Shopping Channel. But I am so excited, particularly for this appearance today, because we're bringing Invicta to Canada.
Now, and it's Lawrence Megan, all the way from New York, live in our studios. Dun, dun, dun.
Hey, Carmela, it's great to see you.
Great to see you, too.
It's great to see you, Kim.
Hey, good to see you.
This is one of our best sellers. Every time we do a regulator, we've done about six or seven of them now. Our Adamas is a regulator, our Time Master is a regulator, our Concerto Maestro is a regulator. But here's the Newport Forever, okay? The hands on that watch, those are what we call sword blade hands, and that's a very in look in men's watches right now, is the sword blade hands. It's the StarTech 5050C. It is the only chronograph movement in the world that combines four indicators of a chronograph, which is tenths of a second, seconds, minutes, and hours up to 12, combined with a day of the week and a big date complication down there at 6 o'clock. And as we say with Sterling, we're all about the respect for the art and tradition of the Swiss watchmaking legend, and we mean it. We've partnered with a third-generation Swiss watchmaking company in our factory. Look how great this looks on Charlotte. Genuine pink crocodile strap, beautiful pink mother of pearl.
Wow.
You've got 18 points of diamonds, solid 316L surgical grade stainless steel, and you have a Ronda 762 movement in this piece.
Larry Megan, you are the president of operations for North America of Sterling. It's such a long thing to have to say.
Thanks a lot, Jim. Hey, I'll tell you what, man. I am really, really excited for this show tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Anyway, Larry, how are you, my friend?
Hey, I am great, Jim. This is so great to be here. I want to thank everybody at home.
I couldn't be more thrilled about a watch, O'Leary.
Hey, Sean, it's great to be here with you. I'm very excited. I want to welcome everybody here to the show. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. I want to thank everybody for a great ride this year in 2005. It's been fantastic. Thank you for all the cards and letters. And we have a great show lined up for you tonight. But I'm going to tell you what. You will blow your friends away with this piece at $200. I'm telling you now. Look at the Breguet-style hand. Sapphire crystals. We made a more updated version with Arabic numerals instead of the stick markers, which I kind of like the Arabic. But we did it with a Cristerna crystal. And we did a little other few things. This is the real McCoy right here. This is the real deal. This is the goods, folks. Look at this watch for $200.
Look at the engraving.
Folks, it's one of the finest we ever had, and here we're doing it in a speed show in a blowout deal, $199.
Now sit back and get ready to shop. And now, here's your host.
Woo! Good Saturday afternoon to you, wherever you may be. My name is Larry Megan. This is the world's finest jewelry show and home shopping television right here on the National TV Liquidators. And that is sensational. That is a very large center stone. As you can see, it's a 1.12 carat center stone. All the emeralds are custom cut to fit the mounting. They're top grade emeralds, and you have diamonds all the way around in a beautiful antique setting. Really, really nice. Let's move on. Okay. $27.99, and again, it's got that Art Deco styling, really nice styling. I love the mounting on that, and again, it's got the best intensity of color. This is another hot pink sapphire. It's hot pink. It's from Sri Lanka. Beautifully cut. Great saturation of color. No zoning in this piece whatsoever. Okay, let's move on.
You're watching the Panda America Shopping Network.
You won't believe what we have tonight in Gemstones. If you like Ceylon sapphires, boy, oh man, do we have Ceylon sapphires tonight. I'm so excited to show you these sapphires. They're incredible. If you like sapphires, call it. We are back. We're going to go to a break. Get the break ready. Everybody, we are back. They're sold. Mwah! I love you. My name is Larry Megan. Do you have the break ready? When we come back, folks, everybody call in. I'm going to give stones away
Well, not you got to pay a little bit of money, you know. But I'm going to give them just above cost. Fabulous sale. Thank you very much, Diane. Love you very much. Mwah. We're going to a break. We'll be right back.
Good evening and welcome to Pigskin Chronicles. Playing professional football is a dream of many and a wonderful reality for only a few. There's only a handful of players that can say they played in the NFL. And tonight, we've got three of them right here on one show. And we're going to talk some football. So let's get right to it. Welcome to Pigskin Chronicles, Hop.
My pleasure, Larry.
Nice to have you here.
Man.
When you were getting ready to come out your senior year at SC, you were coming out very, very highly touted. I mean, you were Dion before Dion was Dion.
I enjoy the competitiveness of just of the whole game. I like playing on every side of the ball, each side of the ball. I like, I mean, whatever I have to do to win. You know, this guy, John Elway, had an arm of a grown man in the 10th grade. Give me some tissue. I might start crying again.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Still haunts me today. You know, a lot of folks think, oh, that's just a, you know, it's just a game, this and that. But, you know, when you've been playing for all your life, you know, you played ball all your life, you know, that was your dream. It was like your dream was snatched away from you, man, within not even a second. You know, and then, too, for it to be so cheap, you know what I mean? It's like dying. You know, who wants to die cheap, you know? And that's what I felt like, you know, when that moment happened, it felt like somebody just walked up from behind me and shot me in the head. You know what I mean?
If there was ever a can't-miss running back coming out of college, the Whirly Bird was it. Welcome to Pigskin Chronicles, Tim.
How you doing, buddy?
Nice to see you.
All right.
Well, the Steelers got off to a slow start that year.
Right.
But the second half of the season, you got it rolling.
Yes.
And the Steelers won 8 out of their last 9 games. You led the Steelers in rushing, first rookie to do that since Franco Harris.
Right.
You won the town over with your running ability, and the Steelers had an incredible turnaround, and they almost made it to the Super Bowl, one game away from the Super Bowl, really. And the prospects for the next year in 1990 were just sky high. You were riding on top again.
Yeah. Here I am, a 22-year-old young man, you know, and they give you a couple $1 million to put in the bank. What do you do? You know, and you got people coming at you from every angle, you know, especially girls. You know, at that time I was girl crazy. I had already was experimenting with cocaine at the time, and I remember the night before the DUI, I had used cocaine, right? And when I got that DUI, you know, I was like, it was all over the news, you know what I mean? I was trying to figure out how I was going to tell my mother.
He was named as the NFL Special Teams Player of the Year, Sam Ano.
Thank you, Larry.
But that's just good. That's baseball.
Yeah.
You know? But, you know, it's getting down the wire, and everybody was like, I ain't pitching. You know? And they're like, hey, let's call it. You know?
It was such a blasé atmosphere, you know? And they all their Letterman jackets on, you know? And they all felt like, you know, I'm cool enough.
This is not judgment.
He was
at all here.
This is the wrong group to be judging, so including myself.
Forgot about you, too?
I mean,
listen to you over there on your horse.
You got a few stories.
Listen, I made my mistakes, too. You know, I know that.
In a world made of steel, made of stone.
Introducing Softball America, a softball development company.
You're here on KVLY Sportscope. I'm Bill Seward, and with us tonight, Larry Megan, and Larry is the founder of Softball America.
One thing I learned about softball is once it gets in your blood, it's like a sickness. To initially put softball on television, we would use celebrities and stars and that type of thing. And I talked earlier about the San Diego event, and it was a lot of fun. It was a game between the U.S. All-American team, which was a team of 20 of the top softball players in the country, against a team of Major League Baseball players, and it was put together with a charity, Muscular Dystrophy, and the idea in mind there was the same basic concept that I'm pursuing now, and that is softball on television. The only difference, of course, was that the organized approach was different. The organized approach there was to utilize celebrities and major league names and stars and that type of appeal to get softball on television. Billy Crystal and Rob Reiner were there.
Here's Bill Pollack out of Freehold, New Jersey, and Billy Crystal. Bill is 6'6 and 295. Rob Reiner is warming up here. I love this shot. Here's Alan Trammell cutting the inside of the base here. We had a dinner banquet. Here's my guest of honor, Johnny Bench and Kurt Bevacqua. It's not the approach. I wasn't happy with the final show. It came off too much of a gimmick. And that's how I evolved into where I'm at now in pursuing professional softball. One top-notch softball team on the field against another top-notch softball team going head-to-head, competing.
Listen, I've had a great time. Thank you, everybody. For Sterling Original, I'm Larry Megan. Peace, love, and all good things.
More times than not, a childhood idol, a hero, can spark those dreams.